Hello, soccer lovers. It's another time out on Limitless Soccer with yours truly, Bayole Arashi. Today being the seventh day in the month of February 2016. Well, I'm here again to bring you updates and to look at the high points of major soccer games played across the Europe over the weekend. Of course, we are still in weekend. Today is just Sunday, and of course, it's a very quick one also today. There were big games played across Europe, in Germany, in France, in Spain, and in England, of course. So on this platform, we'll look at the major games, the high points of any games that were played across Europe. But first and foremost, I'd like to say congratulations to the people of Democratic Republic of Congo for winning their second back-to-back African Nations title, played in Rwanda, Kigali. Earlier today, they won that particular game by defeating Mali to take their tournament, to take the trophy back to back. So congratulations from all of us at Limitless Soccer to the people of DR Congo. It shows that you are not just the African champions for nothing, because TP-SAM Mazembe with TP Mazembe are also the champions of CAF Champions League. Congratulations once again to Congo. Quickly, we move on to one major vital issue in Nigeria right now. The head coach of the national team, Coach Okechukwu Sunday Oluseyi, came out this morning in Nigeria with I don't know why he actually shot the video from, maybe it was in his residence in Belgium or probably back home in Nigeria, accusing reporters and journalists that some of them, in fact, he actually used the word insanity, that he wants to actually address the insanity going on in Nigeria regarding people criticizing him or criticizing his game and his performance for the Super Eagles. What do you make of Coach, I want to say Stephen Keshi again, what do you make of Coach Oluseyi's rant via a video? He actually did it in two parts, part A and part B. I think it was uncalled for. In fact, I had a comment on both the videos that was really uncalled for, and he needs to really, really watch his temperament. He was a very, very good player for the Super Eagles of Nigeria, a very good captain, even though it could be controversial sometimes, but emotions cannot be questioned, and his loyalty cannot be questioned to the national team. While he was a player, a lot of us liked him for that, but as a coach, I think he cannot handle temperament, he cannot handle criticism. And if you are going to be a coach of a team as big as the Super Eagles of Nigeria, then you must be ready for a lot of firework. And a lot of us remember why Coach Oluseyi was a TV pundit before taking the job, that he used to be a very big critic of all the people that worked there before, especially his former colleague Stephen Okechukwu Keshi. Very sad one from Coach Sunday Oluseyi there. Maybe a lot of people are saying maybe he's just trying to shoot himself in the foot there, because he went as far as saying he did not actually come for the job, that he was begged to take the job of the Super Eagles. What do you make of his statement? If you want the link of the video, I could actually put it down via this video. You could go to the link of the video and watch what he said. There were two parts, one and two videos in four minutes each. Well, that's about Sunday Oluseyi, because we will not sit here all day to be talking about Coach Sunday Oluseyi. Well, quickly to the leagues across Europe. Yesterday, the biggest game that was played in the English Premier League was that one between Leicester City and Manchester City Football Club, played at the Etihad Stadium. That means Manchester City were at home yesterday. But what happened? Well, it was Leicester City that took the big step and took the whole 3 points against Manchester City, beating Manchester City by 3-1. In fact, the only goal for Manchester City came courtesy of Kun Aguero in the very, very late part of that particular game. Mahrez scoring a very, very, very good goal, and Robert Hood also scoring the third goal for Leicester City. And Leicester are taking this really, really serious, still topping the group, still topping the league, the English Premier League to be precise. And yesterday, a lot of people were saying Arsenal just had to respond to that particular victory. And today also, Arsenal won their game against AFC Bournemouth. They won that game by 2-0. And the biggest game in England today was that particular one between Chelsea Football Club and Manchester United, placed 5th against 13th placed Chelsea, who are the defending champions of the English Premier League. But the game ended 1-1, a very, very, very good game of football. I must say, I watched that game from the beginning to the end. And David De Gea was actually the most outstanding player on that pitch today at the Stamford Bridge. He performed really well, making some very, very big saves. Thibaut Courtois also did very, very well for Chelsea. And the sad one in the game, of course, was that nasty and very horrific injury to that young defender, Kurt Zouma. And all of us on Limitless Soccer want to wish Kurt Zouma a very, very, very quick recovery. That's what I think is part of the hazard of the business. But I think Kurt is a strong lad and he will come back. He was actually screaming, which means that injury was really, really a tough one on him and what was really, really painful. I hope it's not as damaging as it looks on television. So from here, want to say to Kurt Zouma, we wish you all the best and a quick recovery from that injury. Also today, Sunday, wow, it was another game between in La Liga right now. It was a game between Granada and Real Madrid Football Club. I also was opportunity to see that game live as well. And Granada, where they gave a very, very good show at home against Real Madrid. They didn't have a full stadium because the ticket of that particular game was kind of expensive for a lot of Europeans to be able to afford to come to stadium. But still, Nigeria's Isaac Success represented very, very well. The 20-year-old gave a very tough game to the Brazilian Marcelo. But of course, Real Madrid had to like find something extra in the 84th minute. Courtesy Luka Modric, top class finish from about 22 yards. That was a very, very good goal, maybe a contender for goal of the week. Real Madrid going away with that one, winning it by 2-1. But I was very satisfied by the performance of young Nigerian Success Isaac. Right now, as we speak in the French Ligue 1, Paris Saint-Germain are actually leading. Presently, they are leading Olympique Marseille in a very, very tough battle going on there. And check it out, who scored a goal for PSG. Zlatan Ibrahimovic scored the first goal for PSG, while Cabella equalized for Marseille. But in 71 minutes, Angel Di Maria scored the second goal for PSG. We still don't know where that game is going to end. And PSG is still topping the group, followed by Monaco, Nice, and Saint-Etienne taking the fourth position in the French League on over the weekend also. Because, you know, as we look at the Manchester City game now, their new coach that is coming in, Pep Guardiola, will have to keep following him up also in the German Bundesliga. But Bayern Munich, his team could not take all the 3 points over the weekend. They got a draw against Bayer Leverkusen away in that particular one in the German Bundesliga. Earlier today also, Napoli won 1-0 at home against Capi. And of course, who scored the goal? Higuain, the Argentine striker. He can't stop scoring for the side in Naples. And this is the top four in the Serie A. Napoli with 56 points, Juventus with 54, Fiorentina 46, Internazionale taking the fourth place with 45 points. Well, this is practically the little I will be able to give to you this day on this particular episode of Limitless Soccer, as we await the February 16th and 17th day for the UEFA Champions League knockout round to return. I want you to tell me, what is the fixture you are looking forward to the most in that particular, I think the most glamorous league competition in the world after the FIFA World Cup, that is the UEFA Champions League. And also, what do you make of Coach Sunday Oliseh rant on YouTube, and what do you think will be the end of it for him? Were you satisfied with the game between Manchester United and Chelsea? Drop your comment, keep subscribing to my channel, and don't forget the highlights of the Leicester City against Manchester City is right here on my channel, on the YouTube channel here. You could search for it. It's right there under soccer highlights. And also the Manchester United against Chelsea game is also right there on the vlog, on the YouTube page. This vlog is open for sponsorship because we'll be going on TV very, very soon. So you could also follow me on all my social media platforms, on Instagram and Twitter. I am at Maida Soccer, and my name on Facebook is Bayonle Arashi. Follow me, send me a friend request, and of course, we'll take it from there. I want to wish you guys the best week ahead and hope you keep being yourself and being awesome. God bless you all. Bye-bye now.